Why do we create art? Some say it's our need to see our legacy outlive us, to see our individuality preserved forever. But what if your art was anonymous? What if your message was so universally important that your identity was entirely irrelevant? Fame was not what you sought. Instead, you only wished to communicate the incommunicable. This is my story about discovering the truth behind the mystery of human expression and unveiling all the confusion that goes along with the abstract. It all started with a simple story told by my drama teacher, Stephanie Davis. She told us about an art student who worked with her at Starbucks. His trademark was abstract pink art. His name? Pepto Bismol. His identity was a complete secret. My curiosity was sparked, but I didn't look too much into it. Until one day, during a routine Starbucks visit, an anonymous phone call provided just the fuel I needed for an investigation. Hello?
Indigestion. Go to County Line and Sherman for the cure you need.
Who is this? Hello? That was weird. Someone just called me and told me to go to County Line and Sherman. Is this something to do with Pepto Bismol? Let's check it out. And so I was off. I knew where I was going, but I had absolutely no idea of what I would find once I got there. I don't know what I'm looking for. I mean, is it supposed to be something like shoes, like pink shoes on a telephone? What is that? Is that it? There. They're right over there. See? See it on the telephone pole? I mean, the wire thing? See it? That's pink. That's gotta be it. We got to check this out. I don't know. What is that, though?
Good question.
It's like a stuffed animal pig and like a... Is that a stocking? And like feathers and pink balloons and like a pink bottle with like a message in it? I guess if he can do that, if he can put that up on a telephone pole, I mean, who knows what else he's got out there. Well, I guess we see all there is to see. What? It's that caller again. Hello?
Your search for the pink one. At Greendale Center, this Friday at 5:47.
What? Hello? Who is this? They hung up. It's the second time I've gotten an anonymous call. I don't know if they're trying to help me on my search or if they're trying to hurt me. I don't know. All I know is I guess it looks like we're going to have to wait till Friday to find out. And as I walked back to my car, I realized that I wouldn't be able to just walk away from this. I had to know more. I started my investigation at Starbucks, where I knew he worked. Andrew was the first employee I questioned about Pepto's art.
Usually it's going to be pink in color, and it could be anything from dismembered stuffed animals to pictures of people painted pink to just pink spills on the floor. You never know when you're going to come in and find something of any random color.
Andrew did find a few Pepto pieces for me to look at. But with Valentine's Day swiftly approaching, it was difficult to tell the difference between a Pepto piece and a seasonal item. I also decided to ask Chad a few questions.
And he also leaves pictures, but they don't really show you anything. They're abstract.
Unsatisfied with my ignorance, I decided to return the next night in hopes of finding more clues that would eventually lead me closer to Pepto Bismol. What I got, however, was almost too much for me to handle. Apparently, Pepto Bismol himself had heard about my little investigation and had decided to leave me a personalized piece, including a note that said, "Be careful what you wish for." As confused as I was when I got the message, things were about to get a lot weirder.
It all starts with a man named Banksy. Then you need to look up a group. This is international. You need to look up a group called the IPD. This is Indianapolis. You need to look up an art student named XX. Herron Art School. That'll take you to Pepto Bismol.
Wait a minute, Herron Art School? I think I remember Andrew saying something about that.
Pepto actually coined his stuff off something he picked up, just a few minor things off Herron where they go to school.
I've heard stories of people finding them around Herron.
So, I went to the only place I could think of, Herron Art School. Once again, I found myself without the slightest clue of what I was looking for. It wasn't until I found a strategically placed statue that things started, shall I say, looking up? Remind you of anything? I was looking at a genuine X-Lax piece. I had found proof of Pepto Bismol's inspiration. But what about this Banksy character? Was there still more to this story? Finding Banksy was a lot easier than I expected. I was glad that Banksy had an official website. Maybe now I could finally find the answers I was looking for. Banksy is a street artist who lives in Britain. His specialties are profound stencil graffiti and the mounting of fake art in prestigious museums. His pieces are controversial, but some people draw comfort from his messages. Banksy is all about getting people to admit to the problems that our society has created. He boldly goes where most people are too afraid to explore. His identity, much like Pepto's, is a complete mystery, but his work is reaching thousands of people every day. So what exactly does Banksy have to do with Pepto and X-Lax? Everything. These artists are united with common goals. They're all trying to stir a revolution of the mind. They all believe in a world where no one is afraid to speak up. They all believe in the perseverance of individuality. And those kinds of ideas are too profound for anyone to take credit for. For these artists, it's not about the glory. It's about changing perceptions through unconventional communication. It was then I realized that all of my previous presumptions had been wrong. I shouldn't have been trying to find out who Pepto was, but rather what he does and why. I had been asking the wrong questions. But now, I understood. With a changed perception, I returned to Starbucks to apologize for my presumptuous investigation. Luckily, there was no long-term damage done, and I sunk back into my role as just another customer. I decided to officially close the case and let life as Pepto knew it go back to normal. Yet a part of me knew that nothing would ever be quite the same.